Hello there, YouTube. This is Necrostevo, and we are here with a very belated week number. This is going to be week number 9 in the Pokemon Premier League, up against the Norwich Skitty, who are coached by the Don Fanatic. And our work was definitely cut out for us in this matchup. I'm happy I'm finally getting a moment to upload this, or rather, taking a moment, because with preparation against Pokemon like Mega Latios, Skarmory, Florges, Nidoking, Zoroark, Heliolisk, why did we let him get Heliolisk again? I feel like as an opponent, someone should have just drafted Heliolisk so that he couldn't have it again, because he's too good with it. But that's okay. Fortunately, Mega Abomasnow actually threatens a good amount of his team with just nice stab coverage. I just went full special attack with a mild nature to really be able to spam Blizzard where I could. Went with a nice choice Scarf Pangoro because I figured he might bring Scarf Darmanitan. And if I can force that thing out enough where if he gets locked into a Fire-type move, then I can bring in Chandelure. If he gets locked into a Ground-type move, I can bring in Rotom. If he gets knocked into a Rock-type move, I can bring in Clefable. So, I kind of wanted to be forcing that thing out as many times as possible and kind of whittling it down where I could. I was really worried about him bringing Gastrodon Skarmory. I tried and tried to breed Hidden Power Fire onto Abomasnow. It was not successful at this time, and I also don't have a Hidden Power Fire Rotom. Otherwise, that would be pretty nice there to kind of catch some things that he had on switch in. But that is all pretty good. I did actually end up bringing Assault Vest Chandelure to this matchup because I figured Chandelure could take hits from Florges, Heliolisk, and Gastrodon if it really, really needed to. It's actually a set that was passed to me by Guy way, way back last year at some point. So I kind of modified the EVs from some to maximize it for this matchup. But otherwise, I did have just the standard Energy Ball, Shadow Ball, Flamethrower, and I really just wanted to be able to kind of take hits and deal out some damage. Abomasnow is my lead just because I want to get it Mega Evolved as soon as possible. I was a little bit dismayed to see Heliolisk right at the start of the battle. Well, that makes sense. It allows him to get a nice fast Volt Switch option. And I'm actually just going to stay in here predicting him to Volt Switch a little bit unnecessarily risky right at the beginning when Abomasnow threatens so much of his team. But I did want to kind of see if he was going to use Focus Blast or anything like that. Because I am a mild nature, I might live it, unless he's just super offensive with Modest Nature or something like that. But yeah, I get to spam Blizzard, and that means I get to see what type of Florges this is. And that Blizzard is almost a 2-hit KO. With Stealth Rocks up, it is a 2-hit KO. So that's really, really good to see. That means he's most likely max Special Defense. I was tempted to run Wood Hammer in order to hit the Florges, but I didn't want to use up my HP in that manner. His Florges just goes for a Wish as I do switch in Assault Vested Chandelure here. It's designed to kind of take on Florges because I don't have anything else really good for absorbing those hits. Here I just go for Flamethrower to kind of gauge how much damage I can do with it. I'm not very invested on my special attack at all. I'm much more defensive. As you can tell by how well I take that Moonblast, Florges has no slouch on special attack even when it's not invested. Now, I did figure, okay, he got his Wish back. Is he just going to Wish again? If he is going to Wish again, he might try to pass it, or he might use this opportunity to try to switch in maybe Darmanitan or Gastrodon. But he actually goes for Toxic. I switched out here expecting him to Wish again, because now I can threaten him with a nice, crispy bullet punch. And he doesn't really have anything besides Skarmory that wants to come in to take that. I was very, very tempted to either kind of overpredict here, but we're just going to go for a U-turn expecting him to switch. I'm banded, and that's a max physically defensive Gastrodon that he has, and so Gastrodon doesn't really like taking those banded hits. And so I go ahead and go back out into my Abomasnow now. I figured, I might be able to threaten him out with the Giga Drain, and if he wants to switch out into Skarmory, then I get to see if he has leftovers or anything like that. So I'm just going to keep on spamming Blizzard because that's the best move to go for. Even if he had stayed in with Gastrodon, it could have KO'd him because he was more physically defensive. We're going to switch out again here, expecting either Rocks or maybe the Steel-type attack. Chandelure kind of comes in on that all day unless he has Rock-type coverage, like Rock Tomb, maybe Rock Slide. And now that we're in here, I can just start going for attacks again. I did expect him to switch out, but I didn't know if he would go into the or if he would go into his Fortress or the Gastrodon. I was actually pretty pleased by how much damage that Flamethrower did, and that means I can definitely take it out from this point with Energy Ball. And this is great because now we have dismantled part of his defensive core, and he won't be able to switch around as much. Now he goes into Nidoking, and I calced it. Unless he is just like a weird bulky Nidoking, I can't live in Earth Power. And so we're going to go out into my Pangoro here, and he shows that he is physical. So that is definitely good that I didn't stay in there. If he were special, he actually might have KO'd me because I did put a little bit. I only put enough speed on Pangoro to outspeed uninvested Skarmory. And then after that, I put it all into HP and defense. So I had a little bit better chance of taking those physical hits from the Nidoking. Now, as he goes out into Skarmory here, I fear he's definitely going to set up his entry hazards because he can't pass up such a great opportunity when that damage from my Pangoro clearly indicates that I'm not banded and I'm scarfed. But since he doesn't have his leftovers anymore, he can't offset the hail damage, which is really nice. Now, as he goes for Roost here, I actually predicted it. Go for Earthquake, get a huge game-changing crit. Without that crit, this would have been a completely different match because now he has to go out into his floor just to take a hit. I just went for Ice Shard there in case he wanted to try to stay in and Roost again or anything like that, because then I could outspeed him and finish him off. Here he finally shows the hidden power Fire. I figured if he had it, he would have used it earlier when I had an Abomasnow versus Florges, but he just went for a Wish. But because of that crit, I'm able to get a free Blizzard off onto his Florges, and he does not have a Wish incoming. And this means that I can kind of dismantle this core a little bit better. Once again, I'm in a position to just go for Ice Shard, and Skarmory comes in and goes down. So now Skarmory and Gastrodon are missing in this matchup, and that kind of means that my Pangoro can have a field day because he comes in with a Nidoking, takes critical damage from Ice Shard. Abomasnow has basically done a fantastic job. I didn't want to risk anything coming in taking that damage from Nidoking, and it actually turns out that his Nidoking is not scarfed and his Darmanitan also isn't scarfed, and so that means we get to go on a little bit of a tear here with Earthquake. Earthquake is going to easily KO the Florges, and I also wanted to carry Earthquake just as a better option to hit things like Nidoking or even Darmanitan, hit that weakness. But since Darmanitan's not scarfed, he actually doesn't have a way to stop Pangoro. And here, maybe he has Sucker Punch on Nidoking, but he does not. And so Nidoking goes down too. And since his last remaining Pokemon is the Heliolisk, if it were scarfed, he would have brought it out earlier, I'm assuming. And it's not sashed, so Heliolisk goes down as well. Scarf Pangoro, putting in a ton of work here off of a huge crit from Mega Abomasnow. So that means that that battle is going to end with a 5-0 in our favor, which is a huge turnaround because before this battle we were actually in the relegation zone, and I'm pretty sure he had only lost two battles before this. So his season was going really, really well, and we kind of put a huge damper on things. Unfortunato, but we definitely will take those. It's kind of reminiscent of last season when I had some matches in the bag and then just some bad hacks happened. So I guess this time it's our turn, and we'll definitely take that for week 9. We're actually going to be up against the, I think that's RTK's team. So look forward to that, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day, guys.